Hey everyone, this tutorial is going to be about how to use PowerPoint's built-in arrangement options or arrange tools on multiple text boxes or multiple images so that you can have perfect alignment and perfect distribution. And I'll show you what I mean here. So right now you can see I just have these three text boxes. Each of them has this sort of dummy text or placeholder text in there. And I want to create sort of a page design where I have three different columns of text. So I've just inserted these text boxes and kind of dragged them around. One of the cool things about PowerPoint is that you really have sort of a blank canvas, and it's not like Word where, you know, you have to sort of anchor things on the page, or if you move one piece of text, then everything else moves along with it. Everything just stays wherever you put it and place it on the page, which is pretty cool. But that can also create some confusion or some kind of sloppiness or messiness in your text boxes that you create, because you're not always putting them exactly where they need to be. Although now the built-in you could actually see that sort of red line. When I move it, it actually tells me when they're aligned. So you can do that sort of manually, of course, like this. And once I get that red line, now it looks like all the boxes are along the same plane there. So that's kind of one way to do it. But the other way to do it, and you can do this with objects or text boxes, and I'll just move these so that they all kind of look like they're in different heights. But all you need to do is select each of them. So I'm going to select all three of them, and I'm going to go ahead up to the Home tab over here to the Drawing Tools, and you see this Arrange button. Just click that, and then you'll see the drop-down menu all the way down here to Align. And these are all the Align tools. So I could actually align all of the text boxes to the left. I could align them all to center, align them right, align top, middle, or bottom. And right now I want to align them all to the top. So I'm going to go ahead and click that, and you will see that they all aligned perfectly to the top. Now, never again should you sort of use those arrow buttons left, right, up, and down to sort of nudge those objects into place. Make sure that you're using the arrange tools to perfectly align those objects. Now, the other thing you can do with the arrange tools is distribute objects. So you can actually see that my text box 1 here, 2, and 3, they're not exactly evenly spaced out across the page. There's less space between number 2 and number 3 than there are this first and second column here. So actually, let's make it even more drastic here. Now I have these two, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure to highlight all of the text boxes. So just go ahead and click that box, push shift, and click the other two so that they all are selected together. You can see they're all selected because all the text boxes have these sort of highlighted lines around them. I'm going to go back up to the Arrange Tools. Now I go down to the Align button. Now we've already aligned these boxes to the top, so we've already done that, but now I want to distribute them horizontally evenly. So you can go down here and you can see you could distribute horizontally or distribute vertically. Now I'm going to distribute horizontally, and they should all snap into a perfectly spaced three column layout. Let's click this and see what happens. Perfect. Excellent. So you can see that they're all spaced perfectly, they're all aligned perfectly on the top, and they're all spaced out perfectly on that horizontal plane. Now you can do this with text boxes, you can do this with objects, and you can do this with a mix of text boxes and objects too. So let me show you this. I'm going to insert a couple circles, just a couple circle shapes here. You know, maybe I'm creating a diagram and I want them all to maybe show like three steps of a process or something like this. Let's actually make this text really big. So step number 1, Control C, Control V, that's going to copy that circle. And I'm just going to make, say that's step number 2. And I'm going to Control C, Control V to copy the circle. And this is going to be step number 3. Now, you know, I could just manually move these like this, but you can also distribute them, align them and distribute them perfectly. So one thing that I like to do when I have all these objects is you can actually highlight everything. You can either click and then push shift, or on a PowerPoint side, you can actually click outside of the circle and then drag over all of the objects, and that will select them all at once. Pretty cool trick. Alright, so they're all selected. Now I'm going to go back up to the Arrange tool. I'm going to align them. Let's align them to the middle this time. They're all going to align to the middle. Perfect. And I'm going to distribute them evenly horizontally again. Awesome. So now you have perfectly spaced, perfectly aligned, and perfectly distributed objects. Never again should you be nudging objects into place. Definitely make sure that you're using the arrange tools to do that alignment. All right, thank you very much for watching, and tune into the next video, which is going to be about inserting shapes and lines as design elements in your report.